Chip Davis.
Boy, I thought I was in my home state of Nebraska there with all this snow. We just had 8 inches last week, and I think it was about 20 degrees or 15 degrees. A little different temperature than it is here, that's for sure. But that's all right. By tomorrow night, I'll be right back in it. Anyway, I thought I'd tell you a little bit about how this concert got started. I've been talking to some friends here in the creative department and management at Universal for a couple of years about, oh, wouldn't it be cool if we could do a show together? And I thought, well, yeah, let's try something. So we tried a short 20-minute version. It was in a different part of the park. It got a really good reaction, so kind of decided maybe we should try something a little longer. We did that, and then it evolved eventually into this concert version. So that's what you're seeing now. It's like, this goes back about 13 years, 12 years ago, something like that. Anyway, that's how the whole thing started, and I thought you might like to hear a little background on it. And now, next, we'll have some Grinchmas.
And now, please welcome the talented performers of Universal Orlando's Grinchmas.
Inside a snowflake, like the one on your sleeve, there happened a story you must see to believe. Way up in the mountains, in the high range of pontoons, lay the small town of Whoville, the home of the Whos. lanterns were being hung by the windows with care, in the hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. Working through the night and all through the day was the decorating committee, led by the lovely Martha May. Little Cindy Lou had questions in her tiny Who heart about the Grinch and Christmas. Where did it all start?
Thank you.
Then the Grinch got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. The Grinch laughed in his throat, and he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat, and he chuckled and clucked. What a great Grinchy trick! With his coat and his hat, I'll look just like Saint Nick. I'm speaking rhyme at last. You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. I'm a big one. I'm the Grinch. My heart's an empty hole. My brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. Oh, I wouldn't touch me with that. 39 and a half foot tall! You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile.
Finding out now that no Christmas is coming.
Then the Grinch heard a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. But the sound wasn't sad. Why, this sound sounded merry. And he puzzled and puzzled till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he had before.
Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.
Welcome, Christmas. Bring your cheer. Cheer to all who's far and near.
Christmas Day's in our grasp. As long as we have hands to clasp, Christmas Day will always be, just as long as we have been.
Welcome Christmas while we stand, heart to heart and hand to hand.
And the music of Mannheim Steamroller.